Hey guys, let's take a look at the following integrated rate law questions in the following video. So here, it says the oxidation of ethane follows a first order mechanism with a very high rate constant, and remember rate constant is K, lowercase k, of 32 seconds inverse to form H2O and CO2 as products. If the initial concentration of ethane is 4.12 molar, what is the concentration after 1.12 times 10 to the negative 3 minutes? Now, what we need to realize here is we're asked to find the concentration. So we're looking for our final concentration. Here, this is our initial concentration, so this is AO. And here they give me minutes, which is time. What we need to remember here is that K and T have to both agree in terms of the units used for time. Time here is in minutes, but our rate constant K here is in seconds inverse. Remember, time must always agree with K. So here we have to change minutes into seconds so that those seconds will match the seconds inverse of our rate constant K. So we're gonna say here, for every 1 minute that we have 60 seconds. So minutes cancel out, so I have that number times 60, which gives me 0.0672. seconds. So now my time T and my rate constant K are both in the same units of time. Now we're dealing with first order, so that means we're going to use the first order integrated rate law. So ln of AT equals negative KT plus ln of AO. Here ln AT equals K is negative 32 seconds inverse. Remember, seconds inverse just means that it's over seconds, times 0.0672 seconds. And you can see why you want the units to be the same, because here these seconds cancel out with these seconds, plus ln of 4.12. So now we have ln AT equals, so what we're gonna do here is we're gonna multiply these two together, remember the negative sign in front, plus ln of 4.12. So here ln AT equals -0.7345. So that is what ln of AT is. But remember, we don't want ln of AT, we just want AT, our final concentration by itself. So just approach it this way. We want to get rid of ln, so we divide both sides by ln. Now, we're not really dividing that number by ln, because if you did that in your calculator, it would give you the answer of error. When I say divide by ln, I'm really saying we're taking the inverse of the natural log. Okay, because natural log means ln. So we're taking the inverse of the natural log. So what I'm really saying here is anytime you divide a number by ln, what that really means is it becomes e to that number. Okay, so again, when you divide by ln, you're not really dividing by ln, it becomes e to that number. Does not change the sign at all. Here this was negative, here it's still negative. And we got rid of that ln here for AT, so now AT is by itself. So when you punch that into your calculator, e to the negative 0.7345, you're gonna get for your final concentration 0.4797. Since initial concentration was in molar, final concentration will be in molar. So that would be our answer to this question. And that's the approach you need to take in order to get the correct answer. So remember, first order, this is our integrated rate law for first order. And then remember, when it comes to our rate constant K and our time T, they both must agree in terms of units of time. Here, K was in seconds inverse, but time was in minutes. So change time T into seconds as well. It's easier to manipulate time T than to manipulate rate K constant. Don't ever try to manipulate the K constant, because it's not as easy as you think it would be.